covering the week's top tech stories with a slight Linux bias.
Microsoft is urging users to abandon telephone-based multi-factor authentication solutions like one-time codes sent via SMS and voice calls. The warning comes from Alex Weinert, Director of Identity Security at Microsoft. For the past year, Weinert has been advocating on Microsoft's behalf, urging users to embrace and enable MFA for their online accounts. Citing internal Microsoft statistics, Weinert said in a blog post last year that users who enabled multi-factor authentication ended up blocking around 99.9% of automated attacks against their Microsoft accounts. But in a follow-up blog post last Thursday, Weinert says that if users have to choose between multiple MFA solutions, they should stay away from telephone-based MFA. The Microsoft exec cites several known security issues not with MFA, but with the state of the telephone networks today. Weinert says that both SMS and voice calls are transmitted in clear text and can be easily intercepted by determined attackers using readily available techniques and tools. SMS-based one-time codes are also phishable via open-source tools like Modishka, CredSniper, or Evil's Jinx. There's another issue with SMS-based multi-factor authentication that we talked about back on episode 570, when an AT&T kiosk employee was responsible for a SIM swap that resulted in $240 million in Bitcoin being stolen from a customer. Phone network employees can be tricked into transferring phone numbers to a threat actor's SIM card, allowing attackers to receive MFA one-time codes on behalf of their victims. On top of these, phone networks are also exposed to changing regulations, downtimes, and performance issues, all of which impact the availability of the MFA mechanism overall, which in turn prevents users from authenticating on their account in moments of urgency. Weinert says that all of these factors combined demonstrate that SMS and call-based MFA is the least secure of the MFA methods available today. An excellent solution is to switch to an app-based authenticator, or for the absolute best security available, you should go with hardware security keys, which Weinert ranked as the best MFA solution in a blog post he published last year.
Multi-factor authentication is huge on lots of subscription websites, but I've found lately, you know, in my line of work, because I've been setting up a ton of accounts everywhere, so many of them will not allow some of those higher end security options. It's basically an email or cell phone through that SMS text. And some of them, they only allow the SMS. So, I mean, I love the idea, but until the industry changes, how do you fill that gap?
Yeah, I think it's important to note that SMS is still safer than no multi-factor authentication.
Yeah.
So maybe it's a case where, like, I think about Payoneer, for example, who just this past year introduced MFA. Mm-hmm. And it's the same kind of thing. It's SMS-based or email-based even.
Yeah.
Even ConnectWise uses email-based authentication. And while that is a little better, I guess email, it's not great.
No.
Not great at all.
Especially with the amount of emails, accounts that are hacked.
Absolutely. And it goes to show, I mean, from a security perspective, you think about, okay, well, if my email gets hacked, now they actually have access to your multi-factor authentication as well, if you're using email-based multi-factor authentication. But SIM card swaps are very, very frightening in that it can be done very, very easily.
Absolutely.
I mean, if an AT&T kiosk worker can make a mistake and believe that you are who you say you are, maybe you've got fake ID. Maybe you
just
got to be convincing. It's social engineering at its best, right there.
Oh, it's totally
walking up to the kiosk and saying, "Yeah, I'm Jeff Weston." I'm not Jeff Weston. He is. If I said I'm Jeff Weston, I've lost my phone. I needed to activate it on my new phone, and they fall for it. Then guess what? Now I've got all your SMS. What if the person who works at the kiosk was a malicious party? What if the person who works there who has the authority and ability to SIM swap on accident through social engineering, what if they were the bad guy?
Yep.
Now all of a sudden that takes a whole new spin, doesn't it? Because, you know, what kind of credentials do I need to get hired at a mall kiosk?
So is
no
there...
offense to anyone who works in a mall kiosk.
No, of course not.
I don't mean that. Yeah. I mean, like, it's not like you have probably gone through an unbelievable amount of security checks and, you know, that kind of stuff. So
right.
That's what I mean.
Big thanks to Roy W. Nash and our community of viewers for submitting stories to us this week. Thanks for watching the Category5.tv newsroom. Don't forget to like and subscribe for all your tech news with a slight Linux bias. And if you appreciate what we do, become a patron at patreon.com/category5. From the Category5.tv newsroom, I'm Becca Ferguson.